Greetings. It just gets curiouser and curiouser. On the web today, I saw the following. DNC, Democratic National Convention, proceeds with two-hour Islamic Juma or Friday prayers. The host committee of the DNC is raising a number of eyebrows after choosing to proceed with featuring Islamic prayers for 2 hours on the Friday of its convention. Yep, the Democrats. Those superstitious Neanderthal ancient text-thumping deity-pumping sycophants. Getting in bed with the devil. And I mean that, literally. Remember, this is the party that hates God. The party that hates all things Christian. This is the party for murdering babies. The party that praises crosses in urine. The party that insults everything decent. The party that calls children a punishment. The party with no respect for authority. Why, just today, Democrats let their mouths speak what their hearts are filled with. Ellen Barkin hopes hurricane kills every pro-life xenophobic gay-bashing son of a bitch at the Republican convention. You see, this is what a Democrat's heart looks like. Cosmetic surgery can never fix that kind of ugliness. Their hatred spills over like a flood. Out of the abundance of their hearts, their mouths speak, and their tweets tweet. Samuel L. Jackson asks why GOP spared by tropical storm. Samuel Jackson tweeted it was unfair that Tropical Storm Isaac had spared the GOP convention and appeared to be heading for New Orleans. He thought it was unfair that the GOP had been spared. He was not understanding God's plan, given the fact that the storm was not disrupting the Republican gathering. Unfair something, the Oscar-nominated actor said. Nola probably effed again. Mr. Jackson evidently has no clue about the God who controls hurricanes, or that the God who controls the wind and waves might not show favor on a reprobate city of sin. But out of the abundance of his heart, his mouth speaks.
Psst, Mr. Jackson, might want to rethink the image of your racist, hateful God.
And today, some Democrat mouthpiece was fired for allowing his pus-filled heart to speak his general hatred of Republicans. Love to have a party with black people drowning. Caught off microphone uttering that slander, he could not help but let the hatred in his heart overflow like the water from Isaac. Out of the abundance of his heart, his mouth spoke. Remarkably, this biased, hate-filled doorknob was fired the same day it was reported. And so I find it fascinating that as much as Democrats hate Christians and God, they are now rushing to find religion, Mohammed's pagan religion, the one religion on earth designed from day one to attack and subvert Christianity, or die trying. And if you really honestly have no idea about the significance of things going on today, I fear for you. In a Clint Eastwood movie, he once said,
"You're not gonna believe what happens next, even while it's happening."
There are simply too many trends and events happening to ignore. Less than 1 month ago, the DHS, Department of Homeland Security, ordered 750 million rounds of hollow point ammo. One does not plink tin cans with 357 hollow point ammo. One kills people with 357 hollow point ammo. They've ordered enough to shoot every man, woman, and child, legal and illegal, in America. Three times over. The Obama administration has Muslim Brotherhood people on staff. The news media praises the Islamic uprising. The dollar is approaching collapse. The Democrats continue to spend as if intentionally trying to bankrupt America. Now, at some point, you have to wake up and realize no one is accidentally that destructive all the time. And this all fits into end time events. And to see the godless Democrats now courting Satan's religion, I can just hear Mahmoud Awful Dinner Jacket in Iran cackling. He will soon have his nuke and the green light from the Obama Oval Office to use it. It is going to be very interesting this fall, with Democrats bending over to Islam. Religion and politics just took a very interesting turn. It is one thing to buy Mexican loyalty by giving amnesty to illegals, but Democrats have no idea of Islam's satanic quest for global dominance. Nor can they comprehend, because they are blind and in rebellion against Almighty God. They really think that because most Christians in America pay only lip service to their faith, Islam will be as quickly compromised and diverted. So pop your popcorn and get ready to watch. Several things I have been studying recently have moved me on the scale. I used to be pan-trib. I didn't care because everything pans out in the end. I do not find myself resonating with that position so much now. And with Alawite Muslims worshipping Bashar al-Assad, and with Democrats actively flaunting their enthusiasm for Mohammedism, they have no idea of the fire they are pouring into their very own laps, or the cancer they are inviting into America's body. The words quickly and speedily come to mind. Think how quickly the old USSR and Eastern Bloc collapsed. Think how quickly the Islamic uprising toppled all governments, save one. Led by an interesting fellow, worshipped before Allah by Muslims. May those who have eyes to see and ears to hear pay attention to what the Lord of the Harvest is speaking to you in your heart. Amen.